This video will explain a new modification we have entered in the adjustment out screen to handle the information about the customer who will have this adjustment. Adjustment out are used to enter the services, some services that are offered to the customer. The part of them that affect the inventory is entered in the adjustment out screen. The part of them that affect the receivables is entered in the receivable adjustment screen or on the sales invoice screen. Now we will go to the inventory module, inventory transactions, adjustments, and select out when asked. Okay, now we can see here that we have a new set of fields, the customer code field with the customer name. The requested job, the charging amount. Okay, these are new fields that have been entered to the adjustment out screen. Now, all what you need to do is just press edit, okay, and then enter the customer code as usual and the requested job and the amount to be charged to the customer. These two fields, the requested job and the charging amount, will not be allowed to be edited unless the user enter a customer code. Customer code is not mandatory. This is because that we have some adjustment out that are not customer services. So for this type of adjustments out, that we leave those fields blank: customer code, requested job, and charging amount. But for the fields, for the services offered to the customer and entered as adjustment out, we will enter the customer code, and the system in this case will allow us to enter the requested job and the charging amount. Whenever I have something like this, adjustment out that is a service to the customer, I can always print a receipt for this adjustment out to pass it to the customer. This can be done by pressing print and choosing the first one, adjustment out receipt. When I press preview, as you see, it says it's coming from the inventory 3000. This is the serial of the adjustment. This is the customer code and name. This is the date of the adjustment. And this is the requested job. Okay, the charging amount is 18,000. And as you see, the system has made it in words automatically, only 18,000 real. And then a list of all the items offered to the customer to make the service and the quantity of each of these items. Okay. Now, after entering this data, we must take into consideration that this data will not affect the customer statement item and will not affect the account of the customers in the ledger. Instead, when we have here in the inventory, in the receivable reports, when we have accounts receivable ledger, okay, and press OK, we will notice two new reports that were added to this report. One is called adjustment out details and the other is adjustment out totals. Let's see the adjustment out details. For every customer, there is a page having the customer code and the customer name, and each transaction of the adjustment out which was given as a service to this customer. So this is the first transaction dated 31 January 2011, and this is its serial, warehouse, its requested job, and the charging amount. And this is the item. Okay, it's a new item, not used. Quantity 3, and the cost is 9.7, and the total cost is 3 times 9.7 gives 29.13. Okay, the second transaction happened in March. Okay, its charging amount is 18,000, yet it has the following items and their quantities. We have here no cost because we just it just happens that I have made costing till the end of February only, but when we make full costing till the end of March, it will show here figures and here figures also. Okay, so this is the first page concerning this customer. The next page concerns another customer. Also, he has two transactions. The first transaction has only one unit code. The second transaction has a bunch of DBME codes and unit codes. Okay, and these have costs, all of them. The third one, this customer has only one transaction, but this transaction contains five DBME codes with their accompanying unit codes. Okay, so this is the adjustment out details. What is the adjustment out totals? Instead of giving me the details of every adjustment out made to the customer in the form of a service, of course, it gives me a total for every customer, how much from every DBME code he has consumed in these services. Let's see. As you see, this customer has consumed the following DBME codes with the following quantities, and this is the average cost, or the total cost, means the quantity times the average cost of each item. So now I have in this report how much from this item was consumed by this customer in the form of a service, and the next customer, and the next one.